talking about mHealth?
Sure have.
It's an important topic, considering more than 75% of the world has access to cell phones. For those of you viewing at home, if you missed the first video, mHealth is the use of cell phones to support health and medicine. For example, it can remind you to take your medicines and go see your doctor. There are some challenges to mHealth, though.
Like what?
In some parts of the world, people can't afford smartphones like you and don't have internet. They also don't have reliable electricity in their homes. They can't keep the lights on, much less charge a phone.
So what's being done to improve this?
mHealth initiatives are being made to work with older phones. Also, there are efforts by companies around the world to make a smartphone that costs $50. It's also designed to use less electricity.
But is there enough money for all these projects?
This is a major challenge. Funding can be hard to find, and it can run out after a while.
Has anyone done anything for funding?
The World Health Organization and the World Bank are pushing governments around the world to set up reliable and continued funding for public health, including mHealth.
Once a project is funded, how do you keep track of its progress?
Well, one way is to make sure a project is doing what it's supposed to by completing evaluations.
Technology changes so quickly. How does that affect a project's evaluation?
That does make things harder. To overcome this, companies and governments are making better and smarter systems. These systems make evaluations more efficient, hopefully staying ahead of the technology curve, or at least catching up.
Another issue is that many mHealth applications can't share information, let alone work together. I want to be able to talk to my friends.
You make a good point. There is a new app out every day, and people use different apps for different problems. Apps working together would make mHealth even better. App developers are working on this as we speak.
What happens to the information that's collected by all these different apps?
Collecting information is just the first step. It doesn't mean anything until it's been studied and then shared. As I mentioned, new systems are being made to pull all this info together and make heads or tails of it. That's what we call big data.
Besides all the data collection, mHealth is also used to improve health, right?
Yes, but people still need to see their doctor in person. mHealth is meant to improve health, not replace doctors or nurses.
So how do we make sure apps are being used, let alone getting the right info to the right people?
This is a challenge now. In the near future, smartphones will get cheaper and more accessible. Tracking an app's use and info will be easier, as will sending the data to health professionals.
Wow, that's a lot of challenges.
It is, but mHealth is making important progress. mHealth has great potential to improve healthcare. Because cell phones are so prevalent, it's an incredibly useful technology in places with limited resources.
Thanks for clearing that up for me. We hope these videos have been helpful in teaching you about mHealth. Goodbye!